This is Vern Tallman at the County Weather Station with tonight's forecast. A weak cold front is moving across the panhandle, so we can expect it to be getting cloudy and windy by this evening. Temperature in the 50s. I don't reckon you folks down in the valley ought to start worrying about your smudge pots just yet, but if I had a new foal, I'd keep him in the barn tonight. Oh, and there's an 80% chance of rain. You know what? It's a lot nicer out in Waco, San Antone, Houston, or even Lubbock. But this is Vern Tallman telling you to have a nice evening anyway. Here?
Everybody knows when you go to the show, you can't take the kids along. You've got to read the paper and know the code of G, P, G, and R, and X. And you got to know what the movie's about before you even go. Tex Ritter's gone and Disney's dead and the screen is filled with sex.
Whatever happened to Randolph Scott riding the trail alone? Whatever happened to Gene and Tex and Roy and Rex the Durango Kid? Oh, whatever happened to Randolph Scott, his horse plain as could be? Whatever happened to Randolph Scott has happened to the best of me.
Everybody's trying to make a comment about our doubts and fears. True Grit's the only movie I've really understood in years. You've got to take your analyst along to see if it's fit to see. Whatever happened to Randolph Scott has happened to the industry.
Whatever happened to Johnny Mac Brown and Alan Rocky Lane? Whatever happened to Lash LaRue? I'd love to see them again. Whatever happened to Smiley Burnett, Tim Hope, and Gene Autry? Whatever happened to all of these has happened to the best of me.
There he is. He always takes out the cash about 2 minutes after the last show starts in.
Who does?
The manager, the guy you're looking at. See, we jump him in the snack bar before he can get to the safe in his office.
Sure is a long way away. Hey, there's the manager.
Uh-huh, yeah.
Now, we jump him at the box office, right?
Wrong. If we did that, them two'd have us quicker than you can say God with your mouth open.
67, Roger.
What a friend we
Hi, Alamo Drive-In. Uh-huh. Well, our feature tonight is Disaster 76 with an all-star cast. Yes, it'll start at sunset, and we're giving out rain checks in case it, well, you know, rains. Well, thanks for remembering the Alamo.
You know, we're gonna be the only kids in town ain't gonna see this movie tonight.
Well, Henry, you're wrong twice. In the first place, we'll be here tonight. In the second place, we ain't been kids since Jesus was a lance corporal.
This here's the ticket booth, and here is the snack bar. How the hell come you get to draw this man? How come I can't do it?
To get to be a bigger idiot, you'd have to put on weight. Now, you suppose them big city hit men or even the lowest meatball in the whole mafia is gonna stand around wasting time arguing about who draws up the plan?
Well, I don't
know. As long as the plan gets drawn, don't matter a doodle who does it.
Well, if it don't matter, just give me the pencil. Gifford, I can draw this thing. Look, right over.
How'd you know he's here?
I heard you hollering clear down the highway.
Did you get it?
Well, of course. We're just like Monkey Ward's. You place your order and we deliver.
Woo-wee.
Well, of course, unlike Monkey Ward's, we COD.
It is beautiful, gentlemen. Thanks kindly and all that.
Hey, Bill Hill, how come young stud like you's getting married willingly?
Well, hell, he don't want to go knocking up Mary Louise without he marries her first.
Exactly. I am a straight arrow and an all-around nice guy.
Also all-around smart.
What's that mean?
Mary Louise is Daddy's sheriff.
It looks like everywhere I go, always get myself in trouble. Cause the girls I pick on ain't the safest kind.
This Idaho flyer on US 80 West at marker 75. Any good buddies out there? Come on.
Idaho, this here's Black Coffee. What's that drive-in? Pair of Smokies living there. Come on.
Damn, they're right outside my back door.
Can you lose them?
Why not? I'm running empty. Got on nothing but a load of post holes. I'll give them a big hammer.
Dallas, and a dozen pair of boots along the way. Now Betty was a sweet thing I was courting in Seattle. She swore to me she was nobody's wife. But how was I to know she had a boyfriend, Big Dallas? And I traded one blue shirt for one good life. That's why I left the blue shirt hanging on the bedpost in Seattle. My Levi's blood on San Francisco Bay. And I left the Stetson hanging in a hallway down in Dallas. A dozen pair of boots along the way. Now Susie had a big yacht. We anchored in the harbor.
Idaho Flyer. Idaho Flyer. Are you still there? Any sign of them stupid hillbilly Smokies?
Only you can prevent forest fires.
Why, hello, Al. Hey, the Idaho Flyer. He must like our jail.
On the bedpost in Seattle, my Levi's put on San Francisco Bay. And I left the Stetson hanging in a hallway down in Dallas. And a dozen pair of boots along the way. That's why I left the blue shirt hanging.
That there's big-hearted Al Reese's heart beating for you. And in Al Reese's Dodge, Plymouth, and Jeep, Al is all heart. Mm-hmm. Just listen to these big bargains. It's just like stealing, but more fun. Now, Al's got a, just listen to this, a 68 Ford half-ton pickup, Cherry, just used around town hauling pillows and other light stuff. Mm-hmm. She's black and beautiful. A real heart stopper at $14.95.
Jeez. Your grinder's done to Eddie J. What the rooster done to the chicken?
You just don't you bug, man, because I got to strategize.
Tonight? Total war?
Have you got a big flywheel?
I'm talking zap.
Zap him, gear grinders. I know exactly where to find Diddle Brown on a Friday night.
At the drive-in.
That's right.
Eddie J., you look like you've been loving up to a chainsaw.
You're going to have to get a whole lot better to die.
You just don't worry about it there, Eddie. We're gonna take care of him for you. Just rest it up. Speak up. I'm trying to talk to me, buddy. You don't smoke?
Never ask for whom big-hearted Al Reese's heart beats. It beats for thee. Uh-huh. And he's beating all deals that big-hearted Al Reese's Dodge, Plymouth, and Jeep. Get on
once
down there.
I made a promise that I'd never lead you on. But I feel the yearn to love you, even though I know it's wrong.
You'll have to take my hand and lead me slowly through the door. I'll be wrong in what I'm doing. I can't refuse you anymore. Lead me on and take control of how I feel. I can't do this on my own, 'cause it's against my will.
I need love warm and tender.
Hi, Orville.
Well, hi, Miss Downey.
Oh,
That is why you got you no girl.
Miss Downey? Oh, you're Josh, and she's old, maybe 23, 24.
Well, it don't seem to bother her none. Anyways, her husband's off on a pipeline job in Baja, Arkansas.
Now, what is Baja, Arkansas?
Oklahoma.
You know you're late.
They kept us over for sex education.
Oh, you don't need that. You're too young.
So you say I want to know just exactly what I got to do when I finally get to do it.
Comes natural.
I don't neither. Don't seem to come naturally to you. You're still cherry.
Ain't.
Are too. I ought to know. I've been watching like a bank guard.
Well, what for?
So I can sidestep all the mistakes you make your first time out. Or in.
I'll go with you, but you'll have to lead me on.
Just listen to them in there skating, laughing and scratching like they's having fun.
Sounds to me like they are.
They just think they are.
Ain't that the same thing?
No, they're hurting and bad. What I'm saying is, even though we ain't set the world on fire, we ain't like them kids skating in there. At least we know what we are.
Great. Get back on the floor. Come on, y'all.
Sure do.
Everybody skate.
Pure love. Baby, it's pure love. Oh, you did too.
Cutting in on you there, Theo. Sorry about that.
Bill, Theo.
I got a big surprise for you.
What?
Well, first let's call this meeting to order. Your daddy's got to be a candy maker. You taste so sweet.
Well, I'm keeping all the goodies to myself till you tell me what the surprise is.
You act like your double pot.
Bill, heel.
First time I ever seen you so happy, you were speechless.
That just ain't for me.
Not even Glowy Hudson.
Oh, I've known Orville since junior high, and he's got a mind of his own.
Huh?
I've known Orville since junior high. He's got a mind of his own.
Anyway, she doesn't even know I exist.
He told me back then he wanted a girl who was sweet and honest and lovable. Somebody who wouldn't give him no hassle.
That's me.
Hi. I am, and I sure hope it comes to Enoch's attention someday.
Well, you better start somewhere. I'm 12 and sprouting. I'm fixing to get ready. It's up to you to set an example I can follow.
Glowy Hudson, to the door. You got you a visitor.
Who's been asking for me, Bird?
He did.
Enoch wants you.
Stay out, sweet thing. You want your skates to chew up my rug?
Heaven forbid, Enoch.
I'd rather be down in hell with my back broke.
Well, what's eating at you? Ever since I got my new waterbed, me and you's been drifting apart. You sure got a short fuse today.
It's because I know what's coming.
No, you don't. You see, it's something super heavy, and while it requires my personal attention.
Uh-huh, I knew it. But you want me ready whenever you snap your fingers.
Hey, don't be mad at me. Just be mad you wasn't born a man.
Enoch, that is yesterday thinking, and just plain dumb. I'm proud to be a woman, and I'm too fine of a one to be sitting at home with Marcus Welby on a Friday night.
Doors! Now, you looky here, bitch. You try going out on me, and I'll combine your fine with a sore behind.
Today's news.
What are you fixing to do?
Look around some.
Well, look all you want, but don't you find...
Who do you think you're gonna find another Enoch anyway?
Don't want another Enoch.
Huh?
Going shopping for something better.
What do you mean better? He's got a van.
Sure.
I want somebody sincere, nice, who really cares about me.
Well, there ain't too many of them around.
If they are, they've been giving this town a wide berth.
Yeah, well, all I ever see is Roman hands and cold heart.
Ain't it the truth?
I'm right back where I've already gone. Way it's been. I got over you just now.
If I can have your attention, there's a Chevy out there. Can't read the license number. It's got too much mud on it.
Well, after the drive-in, this could be our next job.
We can't hold up this place. We used to skate here when we was kids.
Well, we used to go to the drive-in when we was kids, too.
It's different. It's under a different manager. Besides, we robbed this place. Couldn't make the getaway.
Why not?
Well, cause you can't drive no car with skates on.
Get myself in trouble. Cause the girls I pick on ain't the same kind. Now I wind up running back.
No
breaks
in the
field. Cause the neck I value most of all is mine. That's why I left the
dirt. Can you read?
Well, yeah, I can read.
What happened?
Oh, my kid brother was out there with a drink on the floor, and the chief guard got after him.
He's rough. He's rough.
In a hallway down in Dallas, a dozen pair of boots along the way. Now Betty was a sweet thing I was courting in Seattle. She swore to me she was nobody's wife. But how was I to know she had a boyfriend in Vegas, Dallas? And I traded one blue shirt for one good life.
Be a couple hundred folk in here. I sure don't remember them looking that good when I was that age.
What, 200 of them at about $1 a head?
That jumps
200.
Up. Yeah, but it's a dollar a head.
It's 200.
But it's 200 separate people.
Right here you are. Come and get your balloon. Right here, get your white color. Get the balloon that you had a while ago. Get the balloon of your color. Here's the blue balloon. Let's go. Here's the blue, yellow.
The men's elimination. The last skater on the floor with an unbroken balloon wins. This ain't no free-for-all, but a test of daring strength and plain old luck. The only rules are the rules of guts and good sportsmanship. At the sound of the whistle, y'all get in there and bust them up.
adorable.
Yeah, I wish one of them was me.
Maybe Orville will take you home.
You cutting out, Orville?
Mm-hmm.
You want to take me home?
Sure he would.
Sure. Okay.
Maybe it's pure love. Milk and honey and Captain Crunch. And you in the morning. Pure love. You're the picture of
like me?
What? Well, sure.
Why didn't you never ask me out before?
Yeah, how come?
Well, I don't know you all that well.
Like to know me better?
We sure do.
Chloe, please button up your blouse and sit up straight or...
Or what?
Or I'm gonna pile up this here car.
They pink, Orville. Pink as bubblegum.
Anyway, you're Enoch's girl.
Was. Past tense, him and me's through.
Well, as for when?
About a half an hour ago.
How come?
We had no relationship. No meaningful relationship.
Glowy, don't be giving me any of those fancy New York words from ladies' magazines.
What's that mean?
Well, you're this town's top girl, okay, but that's not what's important. What? Well, I'd go for a girl so... wore braces. As long as she's sincere.
Glowy, I don't hoe with his talking to you like that. Say the word and me and him will go to fist the city.
It's okay. Orville's just testing my sincerity. I'll bet ever since junior high school, Orville's had a mind of his own. He wants a girl that's sweet, honest, and lovable. A girl that won't give him any hassle.
Right.
How about you going to the drive-in with me tonight?
Why me, Glowy? I mean, of
because
all the guys.
I think you're sexy.
What?
Sexy. If your brother ain't tuned in on what goes tonight, here, as they say on the silver screen, is a sneak preview. Thanks.
God's gonna get you for that. God's gonna get you for that. gonna get you for that. There's no place to run and hide, for he knows where you're at. God's gonna get you for that. God's gonna get you for that. Every wrong thing that you do, God's gonna get you for that.
This doggone world we're living in, it's giving me...
Hey, perfect timing.
Like everywhere I turn, I see a hypocrite. Well,
there's no place to run and hide, for he knows where you're at. God's gonna get you for that. Yeah, God's gonna get you for that. Every wrong thing that you do, God's gonna get you for that.
Back.
Now the preacher and I
just use him in good health.
He's a mighty foolish man. Everybody thinks that he's a gold promised man.
It's good.
But the other night on a country road while I was a driving through, out the preacher making love.
Hey, Orville, heads up!
Huh?
God's gonna get you for that. Yeah, God's gonna get you for that.
Well, get the door.
God's gonna get you for that. Yeah, God's gonna get you for that. Every wrong thing that you do, God's gonna get you for that.
Hey, fellas, wait for me!
Oh, sister Vincent, she likes to testify. She says I always love the Lord.
Whose ragtop was that?
Orville Hennings. That back there was Enoch. Change that to his Enoch.
Sister Bessie, flying out the door. God's gonna get you for that. God's gonna get you for that. There's no place to run and hide.
Hey,
God's gonna get you for that. God's gonna get you for that. Every wrong thing that you do, God's gonna get you for that.
Come on, get out of the way.
God's gonna get you for that. There's no place to run and hide, for he knows where you're at. God's gonna get you for that.
Drive-in. Our first job.
Chop!
You scared?
Yeah.
Me too. But we got to. Yeah. I mean, we can't go around stripping cars all our life. No. We got to think about our future.
And our trucks, too.
Huh?
We strip trucks, too, you know.
Damn, Chevy's always a quart low. Don't make them like they used to. Anyway, you know, I heard on the radio where a fella could do real well at diesel mechanics. You know, I've always liked fixing things. I figure I'd like to learn about that son.
Vans, too.
Huh?
Well, we strip vans, too, don't we?
All right, we strip vans, uh-huh.
Where can you learn about diesel?
Up north, Cincinnati. Takes a whole lot of money, though.
Well, tonight we're gonna try to get us some.
Yeah. You didn't forget nothing, did you?
No, I didn't forget nothing.
Yeah, well, you've been known to. Like that time back in Mr. Dodd's woodshop class when you were changing the blade on that circular saw.
Well, that weren't my fault. Nut come off.
Yeah, it's because there's a nut changing the blade, that's why. Boy, I never will forget that thing. Come flying off, go zipping straight across the floor right at old man Dodd.
Boy, I thought he was going to climb walls, thinking that thing was going to climb his leg.
You didn't forget nothing, did you?
No, I didn't forget nothing.
Well, let's check. Gloves.
You are the most calm, prairie man.
Mask?
If I were you in the river, you'd float right upstream.
Peace.
Gifford, you got no call putting me down so. This here is a tool of my trade. Look. Smooth as vanilla extract. Well, the bricklayer don't forget his bricks. And the plumber don't forget his plumb. And I went and forgot the bullets, and I better go back inside and get them.
Good thinking, Will Henry. Good thinking.
Everybody knows when you go to the show, you can't take the kids along.
You've got to read the paper and know the code of G, P, G, and R, and X. And you got to know what the movie's about before you even go. Tex Ritter's gone and Disney's dead and the screen is filled with sex.
Whatever happened to Randolph Scott riding the trail alone? Whatever happened to Gene and Tex and Roy and Rex the Durango Kid? Oh, whatever happened to Randolph Scott, his horse plain as could be? Whatever happened to Randolph Scott, has happened to the best of me? Whatever happened to Randolph Scott, has happened to the industry?
Please.
No clergyman qualify for student discount?
Yeah, but it certifies as a student at the Oral B. Graham Theological Seminary.
Clergyman, yes. Students, no. Pay the full price.
Overcharging buys a one-way ticket to hell.
Don't you threaten me with hell, boy. That turnaround collar don't mean doodly. Pay the full price.
You got a lot to learn about brotherly love.
Rocky Lane. Whatever happened to Lash LaRue, I'd love to see them again. Whatever happened to Smiley Burnett, Tim Hope, and Gene Autry? Whatever happened to all of these, it's happened to the best of me. Whatever happened to Randolph Scott, it's happened to the industry.
The ring. I dropped it.
Hey, girl, you know what I paid for that ring?
Stay cool. It's in here somewhere.
Well, move your leg. I ain't even married yet, and your finger's already rejecting my ring. Well, where'd it go?
I didn't drop it on purpose. It's right here somewhere in our pickup.
Our pickup? Pretty soon, everything's gonna be half yours anyway.
You believe in omens?
Sure. There's good omens and bad omens.
Well, try this omen on for size.
What's that mean?
Bill Hill, I ain't marrying you. I have definitely forgotten that salt.
Woman. We are in what looks like Ku Klux country, with hordes of honkies staring at me like hungry dogs waiting for a bone, and you worrying about salt?
Baby, now you're a doctor and you have your practice, and the whole world hangs on the wisdom of your words, but you're still chicken shit.
Hi, how are you both this evening?
Here, the rain check.
Oh! Oh!
What are you doing?
Handle your kids right or don't come in here.
Comes in here every week, full car. Buy anything from the snack stand. Brings his own food.
67,
that's a whole other story.
Well, y'all enjoy the movie.
Good evening, folks. Thanks for remembering the Alamo. Now, before we put on tonight's feature, Let's take a few steps to see that the rowdyism of last weekend...
I was hoping we'd get in fast before Glowy meets some other feller.
We?
Well, I got what you two. I gotta look and learn. I got lots to learn.
Anyone who pulls out the speaker is bought, said the speaker.
Dear Lord, keep them greedy, avaricious, no-good businessmen from beating us downtrodden out of our money.
Leave only your parking lights on. When walking to and from the snack stand, keep your voices down. Let the folks enjoy themselves. Keep all your beer bottles and your beer cans inside your car. No throwing them out.
Having a good time?
Mm-hmm.
Then you're going to stay down here, right?
Mm-hmm. Until Glowy shows up. What? Mothers are supposed to share, aren't they?
Share? Now my fist's going to share your mouth with your teeth.
Ah, you're scared you'll goof up. Your one chance to score on some easy leg, and you don't want no witnesses.
Well, don't hurry back.
Back? Back to what? Who sits in the bleachers with no ball game going on?
Why, we gotta look for Diddle Brown now.
That Diddle Brown's a shrewd dude.
I sure hope they hear, because I can't wait to do some stomping.
Looky there!
Marvel's car.
Uh-huh. But he's dessert. We keep him for last. Right now, just keep looking for the main course.
Believe me, I've lived long enough to see plenty of cheapskates. But you take the cake. Take your own mother out once a month. Can't it be to church? Or at least to a good restaurant? But no, my son, the big spender, brings me to an old drive-in.
Then look at you. I'm rich enough to be a national park. Oh, if only they'd had the pill when I was young.
Please remember that the back row is patrolled in order to discourage any behavior inconsistent with our family policy. Now, y'all enjoy the show here.
A New Year's Eve champagne flight for fun lovers. And break out the horns and the hats.
What kind do you want?
Not for me, for the passengers. Who's there?
Hey, honey, you all right?
Yeah, sure.
Look, honey, I know you're sore at the airline for firing you after 20 years of loyal service, but cheer up, something will happen.
You better believe it.
Hey, they're serving free champagne out there. Come on, let's go celebrate New Year's Eve.
Yeah. We'll bring it in with a bang. No radar. And ground control cleared this flight? A ship's captain.
Thank God. Can you sail this one?
Looks like somebody has to. What's your name?
Stewardess Largo, sir. And yours?
Vance. Sherman Vance.
Traffic control. This is flight 747. Traffic control.
Stewardess, what are you doing on the radio? Over.
This is Sherman Vance. A mad bomber wiped out the entire crew.
Well, we make the 11 o'clock news again tonight.
Vance, listen carefully. My name's Ford. I'm in charge of Rio Airport. I've worked out a plan. Brazilian Air Force helicopter standing by right outside. At 50 feet of rope. We're going to tie one end to the chopper and one hang on to the other. Because of the difference in airspeed, we're going to have one chance to swing through that old plane.
It would be easier for us to pass through the eye of a needle.
Spoon, you and Alabama go check out the snack bar, see if Diddle Brown's got here yet.
Hello,
these cheap shortcuts in construction. For instance, no stairs, no...
Stairs are old-fashioned. What idiot's going to walk up 196 floors?
You guys, listen, my ladders only go to the second floor.
Hello, Mrs. Hudson. This is Enoch. Can I speak to Glowy, please? Oh? Well, who did she go with?
Oh, sorry.
Yeah? Bye-bye.
I think sure ain't help you people none. When tears come down like falling rain, you'll call around and call my name. You're gonna walk the way I do.
Hey, Glowy, you know what? In the snack stand, I seen Widowmakers.
You didn't see Enoch, did you?
If Widowmakers is here, so's Enoch. Hey, you're not gonna go looking for old Orville now, are you?
You've done a great job, Margo. Now, prepare for landing.
That love each other do get married every now and then.
But marriage ain't what's happening no more for a woman my age.
Bill Hill, I have seen firsthand. Marriage this young just don't work.
Oh.
Their lives are lost like beads off in a string.
Now, not ours. In a couple of years, we buy a decent house with real grass out front. Not indoor-outdoor carpet. Ain't that what every woman wants?
Reasoning with a woman's like eating soup with a fork.
We're gonna stomp that Orville. Now, bring back so we can see how he plans to fix my door. With his money or his blood.
And what if he don't want to come?
Torch him.
Get yourself a white cane.
Sir, I was sorry.
I've got to get upstairs. The dedication of my new building starts in 10 minutes.
I'll lend a hand here, sir. After all, I am the fire captain.
No, you come with me, please. I need you for your tiki torches under the
gun. Hi, Orville. You come looking for me?
That's right.
Go on home without me, girls. Orville, see I get home, won't you?
I'll see she gets home.
Boy, if anybody can make a live one out of him, it's Glowy.
Yeah, but it'll be trickier than Dapper and Siamese twins.
We gotta see if Harriet's gonna bake his cake for Ozzy.
We're in the den, dear. Let him sit down before you grab it off his back, David.
Hi. Hi, Pa.
Pa.
Where have you been?
Oh, Thorny and I took a little stroll down to Miller's and got a chocolate malted.
What?
I caught a people stationed at both exits.
Ain't but one way Diddle Brown and the gear grinders will get out. Ambulance.
Well, you know that turkey what hit our van this PM is here, too.
Who?
Orville.
Orville? Orville, have you seen him over there?
Well, Spooner and him's gone to get him.
Y'all wheels sport?
Our good buddies.
How good?
Oh, me and him, we's real tight.
You were so tight, how come you're scouting his car? Go,
but
while you can.
I hear and obey.
Going with some girl?
Not right now.
You do like girls.
Well, sure I like girls.
You know who you sounded like when you said that? Tony Orlando. You had that same kind of shy and innocent sound about your voice.
Tony Orlando? Shy and innocent?
You a good dancer?
I got some moves, yeah.
You know, I'm beginning to get real good vibes from you.
I never had. And where's my thanks? You got the balled up nerve to sit there smoking them fancy cigarettes without even offering one to your own mom. Too cheap to give me one of my own. Ought to put you up for adoption. I love you so. Now take that last train to Clarksville. Now I must hang. Sure smells funny. I can't hear you in this noisy railroad station all alone. Kind of tasty, though.
Damn. Good night for it to go and start raining.
So what?
Water get on them points and distributor, we'll have to make our getaway by bus.
No, we won't. There's a brand new rebuilt distributor sitting in there underneath that hood.
Well, who rebuilt it?
These two hands.
Like I said, have to make our getaway by bus.
Folks, we've stopped our feature due to the inclement weather. Now, those of you who ain't feeling patient can use your rain check for a 100% totally free admission tomorrow night. And since the County Weather Service informs us that this front is simply passing through our area, I encourage you all to wait it out and enjoy the conclusion of our exciting feature.
You know who he's got with him?
Who?
Chloe.
Chloe?
We gotta go back and tell Enoch.
Who's we? I ain't going back and tell Enoch.
Well, I can't tell him. He'd stomp my glasses.
Oh, boys, where the heck have you been?
We've been working, don't you remember?
Hey, there's David and Ricky.
Sure, we told you.
Well, yes, but where?
The Emporium.
The Emporium. Why don't you relax for a minute? Breakfast is almost ready.
No, I'm not going to tell him. No, not me. There's rain on my glasses. Maybe it wasn't Chloe. It could have been anybody.
Your money, you saved it up. You buy anything you want. You don't have to ask me.
You really mean that?
Well, yeah, unless it's something ridiculous. What did you have in mind?
I want to buy a car.
A car?
Ridiculous, huh?
We couldn't get the sucker. Too many people standing around and like that.
Wait till the picture show starts up again.
He's got Poon with him, too.
Well, Jake, Ray Kale Welch, it ain't no big thing. Now, y'all go on.
We's happy as if we had good sense.
Yeah, well, I got good enough sense to be tired of sitting here at the drive-in alone and doing nothing.
You know what I think? I think my horoscope needs some geritol. Oh, Chloe goes out and gets herself a new guy, and here I am with you. You know, Capricorn must be rising on the cusp of Uranus. Desperate times calls for desperate measures.
What do you mean?
Let's go get the football team to break training.
All right, come on. Watch out.
Really different, you know what I mean?
Sure. Well, actually, no.
You're not different?
No, I don't know what you mean.
I mean, you're sensitive.
Sensitive? Me?
That's something you never find in guys. Girls, yes, but guys, forget it. For instance, I'm very sensitive.
Hey, terrific.
No, it ain't. I'm what you call vulnerable. I get hurt by insensitive people.
Well, I'd never hurt you, Chloe.
I know you wouldn't. I mean, you couldn't. You're sensitive, too. I'm sorry, Lloyd.
No. You just caught me by surprise, is all.
If I had touched your hand earlier, I'd known how sensitive you are.
Well, how come?
Because it's sexy and real soft.
No, it ain't all that soft.
What ain't?
My hand. Ain't that what you was talking about?
You want to kiss me?
Yeah, sure, but it ain't fair to Enoch.
Hear me good. Enoch's out, and you're in. Or about to be.
Look, it stopped raining.
You gay.
What?
Because I ain't prejudiced if you are.
Well, I ain't.
I mean, if you are gay, no hard feelings. No hard feelings, get it?
I got to go along at my own speed. Now, don't take what I say wrong. But you ain't really all that sensitive.
Me? I ain't sensitive? I'll have you know I'm very sensitive.
No, Chloe, you really ain't. And what you are is bossy. Why, you're so bossy, you'd show the devil how to run hell.
Well, somebody's got to show you, Orville, because what you know about loving, an atheist knows about Sunday.
Hey, sweet thing. They done gone. How'd you like to ride home with me?
I'd rather have a non-specific infection.
There's no inside town. Well, looky what the rain washed up.
Hi.
Well, kiss my transmission.
Enoch. Enoch! Alabama's called him old Glowy.
Well, and I thought my Glowy'd be sitting at home crying her eyes out because she couldn't be with him.
Got faked out a little, didn't I?
Faked out a lot.
Who you here with?
Willa Mae and Biddy Jr.
Better be true.
It is.
Good. Let's go talk to them. I want to say hi.
They took off.
Oh, that figures. There you are.
What are you fixing to do?
Oh, I'm going to kick your lying ass until you look like the leftovers from Jaws. Come in, my sweet.
Young man, are you all right?
Give me a doctor.
Oh. But I am a doctor.
kid. You seen a girl go fast from here? Over there?
Come on, you little bastard.
Get the kid.
Let's run it down again. One, fat ass manager goes to snack bar. Two, you follow. You go in, tell everybody
how
to get
come
on the floor.
I go in and you can stay out here.
Well, you got the piece.
Oh. I can fix that faster than God makes poor folks.
Hey, fool, that thing could have gone off.
Sure wouldn't hit no guts.
You calling me some kind of coward?
Is there more than one kind?
Friend or not, nobody talks to me like that.
Gifford, you do what you gotta do, and I'll do what I gotta do.
You're a regular John Wayne, ain't you?
No, how's come I wasn't scared?
No, how come?
I had the safety on.
No, you didn't. That gun don't have a safety.
Well, it most certainly right there.
It's a butt screw. Holds the grips on. John Wayne.
You racing off means only one thing. You've been giving that leg to some other guy. And keep that shut before somebody sticks something in him. Now just tell me who and where so I can go rearrange his skull. Hey, she don't like talking in front of no crowd of salamis. You guys go get me Orville. He demolished my door and he's got lumps coming.
I've been nice. And you're as sour as a turkey that's hemmed to Thanksgiving. Now tell me,
who's the yo-yo you're here with?
I told you, Betty Jr. and Willa Mae.
Oh!
Get off that waterbed! Your heels go through that waterbed, we'd have to build us an ark, but quick.
Ow! Eat up! I hope there's a special pitchfork wait for you in hell!
Who?
All of them!
Orville Henningsen? That turkey? He don't even belong to no club.
Got more sense than to belong to some dumb club.
Hey, you're talking sassy. I gotta break you of that.
I mean, you sassy as a Cadillac Seville.
1081, 1081, 1081, 1081, 1081, 1081, 1081, 1081, 1081, 1081, 1081, 1081, 1081, 1081, 1081, 1081, 1081, 1081, 1081, 1081, 1081, 1081, 1081, 1081, 1081, 1081, 1081, 1081, 1081, 1081, 1081, 1081, 1081, 1081, 1081, 1081, 1081, 1081, 1081, 1081, 1081, 1081, 1081, 1081, 1081, 1081, 1081, 1081, 1081, 1081, 1081, 1081, 1081, 1081, 1081, 1081, 1081, 1081, 1081, 1081, 1081, 1081, 1081, 1081, 1081, 1081, 1081, 1081, 1081, 1081, 1081, 1081, 1081, 1081, 1081, 1081, 1081, 1081, 1081, 1081, 1081, 1081, 1081, 1081, 1081, 1081, 1081, 1081, 1081, 1081, 1081, 1081, 1081, 1081, 1081
Ranger out of this catastrophic disaster.
Go take off his gas cap. Stick this in. Light it.
We're having an earthquake. Look out. The buildings. They're falling to the left and right of us.
Ali.
They're shooting innocent bystanders left and right.
I don't like the looks of that dam. I can see the cracks from here, and it's 4 miles above.
Find that ring nowhere.
I want to function in this world. I want to be somebody.
You will be somebody. Mrs. Bill Hill.
After college.
College? Where are you going to get the bread? She ain't smart enough for no scholarship, and you sure ain't no minority.
Well, then I'll go to state.
That takes bread.
Well, then I'll work part-time.
You couldn't make enough to get through kindergarten. Can't find that
well,
ring.
Well, no. I'll figure something.
Figure on marrying me. I make enough to put you through school. Folks do that all the time. We'd be happy as A.J. Ford after a race. Look, I'll go get us a couple of Cokes, and when I get back, tell me what you want to do.
Okay.
God bless your mom and dad.
Hello, Bill Hill.
Oh, hi. Hey, how'd you know my name?
From school.
You and I, You know, I could have never gone to the same school. I mean, there's no way. No way I'd ever forget you.
Pop, you were a couple of years ahead of me. I'm just a junior now. Pay down there.
Ain't nothing junior about you.
You come here a lot?
Used to. I just made a junior. What's your name, anyway?
Omalie Ledbetter.
You work weekends?
Except Sundays.
Maybe we could negotiate a little something. Shake and bake.
Think I can be identified?
Not with nothing human, you can't. Same thing holds true even when you ain't got the mask on. I'm gonna go case the snack bar.
How come you get to go in there and I gotta stay out here?
Well, in a short little while, you're going in with the gun. Less times you go in, less chance somebody will know who you are.
Oh.
Huh.
Well, bring me a hot dog and a Coke. Whole onions.
I thought you liked onions.
Well, not when I gotta breathe through some dumb mask.
Okay, 53. Got.
Give me a couple of large Cokes and a box of popcorn and a couple of hot dogs. On the first one, I want mustard and relish. You cut the onions and put chili and cheese on it. And you can put chili and cheese on the second one, too.
Write it yourself.
What do they pay you for?
To look like Miss America. Move, will you? I'm trying to watch the film. Okay, 16.
Hey, what'd I say on that first hot dog?
Just bacon.
Busy in there belly dancing with a case of crabs. Be still, I'm gonna go inside your head.
You sure they didn't put onions on this thing?
No, there ain't no onions on it.
Well, there's onions on this one.
That's mine. Give it here.
Well, what are we gonna do with him?
Well, he likes to use his eyes. Maybe we just stomp on his eyelids, huh?
Maybe we just use him for a hostage.
Oh, hostage. That's great.
What's a hostage?
A hostage is a bulletproof vest that breathes.
Popcorn.
Ma told me never take no food from no strangers, but I'll take a bite of that hot dog.
Right, just a little bite. Now you
Jesus.
Don't eat half of it.
Jesus, worse than Jaws.
In 10 seconds, you're gonna make hell look like a lightning bug.
Okay, Alabama, light his fire.
Why not take this opportunity to visit the snack stand for a nice hot Dr. Pepper?
Get your foot down.
Oh. Just Josh and Orville.
What'd you tell them that for?
I had to tell them that so they won't chicken up and split before we get back. Come on.
Yes, sir. May I help you?
I'd like two of those, please.
Hot dogs? Yes, sir.
And three of those, and one of those, and five bars of these, and a cup of that nice hot liquid.
Coffee. Coming right up.
Oh, and two bags of those peculiar white coffee material.
You mean our crunchy popcorn. Shall I wrap that for you, sir?
Oh, that's all right. My saucer's just outside.
They come from miles to enjoy our intermission.
Drive-in. How are we gonna get in? We don't have any money.
Daddy said when he's little, Ace the poor, they'd stand around looking at each other, wondering which one he's gonna eat first.
Yeah, well, we ain't doing much better now. You guys told me we was cooking catfish tonight. I had no idea we had to catch it. First, we waste 2 hours, nothing to eat. Then you yo-yos go and blow our last couple of bucks at the Dairy Queen.
That drive-in will be wall-to-wall poon tonight.
Mush on. We'll think of something.
Say, we miss much?
Oh, practically nothing. Give me $3, please.
Say, why don't you fill me in?
Come on, you have to move this car. $3.
Damn thing won't start. Say, sir, you think we ought to push it over against that building so these people can get in?
Yeah, okay. Come on, move it.
Come on, y'all. Hey, what do you think we ought to do now, sir?
We'll try flooring it.
Floor it?
Floor it.
Then what?
We'll put it in gear.
No, the picture.
Oh, the picture.
Yeah.
Well, the dam breaks. Hey, he didn't pay.
He didn't pay? Come on, we'll get him for you, sir. Don't you worry. Used to be nothing but top pun out here.
Last few weeks ain't been nothing but an ugly convention.
Two Saturdays ago, Dillinger got him some first-class leg. She really had it.
Yeah, and she gave it to me.
Little Brown's people, they're here. We just seen them come in.
Just go keep an eye on them like we plan. Hey, hold it down out there.
Woman, you's messy. I like my people pretty.
Slapping a person around don't put her at her best.
It's all over, ain't it, Chloe?
When there's nothing left between two people. Ain't when she's hanging on.
Unless you want to take up with one of my boys.
If I can't be tablecloth, sure as hell don't want to be napkin.
Well, I'm going to be busy, so you just give your Orville a personal message for me.
Hey, that's my knife. Bring it back.
Okay.
No. No!
You got it.
No! No!
Heard of realism, but this is ridiculous.
Orville!
Who's Orville?
My brother.
Well, did he see you?
No.
You're still a hostage.
Yeah.
scalp that bat dwarf. Chloe? Chloe? Chloe, what happened?
I was making out with a cement mixer.
Who done this to you?
None of your business.
You made it my business when you started vamping me this evening.
Vamping? I've been vamping?
You sure as shit.
I never vamped nobody. I don't have to. Most men don't need vamping.
You probably did it to get Enoch jealous.
Orville, I am and always have been a one-man woman. I mean, if there's one thing I got, it is sincere. When I was going with Enoch, I never looked at nobody else. It wasn't until Enoch and I was through that I took my first good look at you.
Well, I don't like hassles, but the time's come for me to strap on my guns and go find Enoch.
Hey, I don't want nobody getting shot at over me.
No, I mean, okay, nobody will get shot.
You watch out. That Enoch's a rough cob. He'll take you apart bone by bone.
Or else he won't.
Sure looking forward to some grab ass tonight.
Who weren't? I've been hotter than a fat lady's girdle. If I don't score tonight, you're it.
Hey, squash it. We ain't checked out that popcorn stand yet. We just might catch some leg in there.
That's Big Tim Four.
Come on.
Help! Help!
Man, overboard. We're all overboard.
Look! What are those great white things coming toward us?
Sharks!
Diddle Brown and them just took off with a popcorn stand.
Well, when they come out, we'll give them a reception. We'll get them before they get word to God.
There's the manager. There's that cash box. Good luck.
Luck? I don't need luck no more than a tomcat needs a marriage license. I got me all together. This here's a new me. Iron backbone, steel guts.
Does he get rusty when it rains? You guys really going through with this? Well, can a hostage say something?
I guess so.
Don't. You two salamis ain't no Bonnie and Clyde.
Widowmaker's Hour.
Tonight, Enoch's special guest is Diddle Brown.
Hey, now, let's talk about this thing like we have good sense.
Hey, how come you didn't tell that to Eddie J?
Before you put him in the hospital.
Look, I never knowed he's one of your people.
Diddle Brown, you got faces on both sides of your head.
Yeah, well, I gotta give you that. But in this case, that boy wouldn't fly in your colors.
Bet you a buck he tries putting the mask over his hat.
Oh,
Could I have your attention, please? This here's a stick-up. Y'all reach for some sky, please. Now, anybody get any ideas, and this kid will get hit in a hail of bullets. Now we get the manager, Gifford.
Don't call out my name in public, you dumb billy goat.
You, fat ass, I saw you put that cash box in that ice cream chest. Put it out here where we can see it.
Everybody hit the floor. Well, now. Oh, not you, stupid.
I knew I shouldn't have come here.
You, chocolate drop, get up.
Chocolate drop? Me?
Yeah, you. And fast.
I'm a doctor of medicine. And as such, a value to all peoples. After all my training, it's just not conceivable that I should die. But if I must, I'll die as a man.
Oh, shut up, MD, before it gets any more uphill.
Getting inside your chest is tempting to me as an unlocked Corvette.
All right, you can take us. You come prepared, but boy, you're gonna know you've been in a fight.
Don't do that, fat ass. You get the strong box, give it to the kid. Now, anybody gets any ideas, this kid's gonna get a hail full of bullets.
I know.
The strong box, give it to the kid.
Don't nobody move, please.
Will Henry.
Gifford, he said my name.
It's all right.
He knows all. We gotta get out of here.
My name,
now, just stay calm. Gifford,
Gifford.
No, it's not. We gotta get out of here.
I shoot him.
Cleaning a school teacher's leg. But we gonna meet again.
Not if I can have it.
Well, you can.
Look at me. I'm as helpless as kitten love.
Maybe there's a reward.
Hey, Gifford, hurry.
You get shot?
No, I didn't get shot.
Who shot you?
I didn't get shot.
You shot yourself. You shot yourself.
No, I didn't shoot myself. I caught my hand in the
air. Dangerous as a drunk hillbilly with a credit card.
Gifford ain't no hillbilly and ain't never had no credit cards. I didn't shoot myself. I caught it right in there.
Well, that's half dumb anyway. I mean, that's dumb.
What kind of a vigilante are you anyway? Get going! Don't even mind you sitting there sweating like your pa used to.
Throw away the cash box.
Yeah, what cash box?
Cash box. Kid's got it. Get from the kid.
Where's the kid?
Where's the kid?
Yeah, where's the kid?
Well, you brought him.
Well, he ain't exactly small. You think I got him stuck in my hip pocket?
Well, I don't know, but I didn't have time to bring him.
Now, you just about put the old fudge icing on the cake.
Well, you baked it.
Oh,
give her a...
Take me with you. Well, you guys need somebody to think for you.
Well, it seems to me like we ain't got about two choices here. One's to get out of this crime business, here and now.
Two?
To wait until after your first jail sentence.
Wasn't what I was going to say, but it'll sure do.
What was you going to say, Will Henry?
Well, let's head on up to North Cincinnati tonight and enroll in that diesel school first thing in the morning.
Well, what do we do for gas money? May be no good, never have been, but I ain't about to invoke no kid on life or crime.
For all the good it's done, we could sell this thing.
You go on and take that box back to the manager. Get yourself a nice big reward.
Happy trails.
They gone? Can you identify them?
Sure, there was two big, super ugly dudes.
Can't you be more specific?
When you big and super ugly, you big and super ugly ain't no more.
What about the car?
Red. Four wheels. Two doors. Steering wheel.
I appreciate what you did for me, Sonny.
You could have anything you want on the house. A free movie ticket, hot dog, popcorn, candy.
Money. Thinking about what you said.
Ann?
Yes?
Yes, what?
Yes, I'll marry you.
Hey, great.
What's wrong?
I'm just surprised. Happy surprised.
I ought to know if something's wrong. Did something happen at the snack bar?
Of course not. What could happen?
I don't know. Something. I mean, you changed so quick. I'm sure you got your reasons.
Two big ones.
What?
There was this holdup.
A holdup?
Yeah, two guys waving guns around. My whole future flashed before my eyes.
You mean your past?
No, my future. Ain't nothing I can do about my past. Already been there. Thought about all the trees I never got to climb. All the ponds I never got to fish in.
I ain't all that interested in trees and ponds unless... Well, if you're saying what I think you're saying, it works both ways.
What does?
Climbing trees and fishing ponds. If a woman goes off to college on her own, she's bound to change some. I mean, there's gonna be at least a couple of hundred books in 4 years standing between us. Can you see me still worried whether your rebuilt carburetor is or is not sucking air? And you too.
Sucking air?
Oh, change. You've changed more in the last 10 minutes than you have in the last 10 years. Here's your damn ring back.
Hey, where'd you find it?
It was in my shoe. I thought it was my corn acting up.
Fella really inherits all sorts of things when he gets himself married.
Yeah, but... I guess you don't have to worry about that now, do you?
What a night.
That's right, Bill Hill. Life just won't sit still for nobody, will it?
For nobody.
Get the door.
Well, hello, Orville.
Oh, whoo!
do is bite.
Don't you get involved. Oh,
get it.
Gang violence. It's frightening.
They're fast.
What's going on here?
Man, I've had a bad day, and every time I look up, it's you. Did my knife spoon. I'd have had him. One more punch and I'd have had him. Hey, you guys. Hey, now come on. Alabama. Y'all get back here right this minute.
It's almost over.
Stay if you like. I'm leaving, and I'm leaving now.
Calm down.
I'm calm. I came here calm, and I'm going to leave here calm. And the key word is leave.
Never in focus.
Don't shoot! Don't shoot, please!
Somebody's got to rebuild Rio.
God's gonna get you for that. God's gonna get you for that. There's no place to run and hide. He knows where you're at. God's gonna get you for that. God's gonna get you for that. Every wrong thing that you do, God's gonna get you for that.
This doggone world we're living in, it's giving me a fit. It seems like everywhere I turn, I see a hypocrite. Well, if you wanna go to heaven, well, you can't live like that. So let me tell you, brother, God's gonna get you for that.
God's gonna get you for that. Yeah, God's gonna get you for that.
Where you been?
Around. I miss all the good stuff.
Good stuff? I near had my head handed to me. Near nothing. He whooped Enoch.
That's impossible. I can't believe it.
You better believe it. It's true. That's right. Or else she wouldn't be sitting here. Wrong, Orville. Wrong. You whooping Enoch's got nothing to do with me being here. I ain't some prize that goes to the winner. But you see, I'm here because I want to be. My choice. Okay. Okay, what? You and me? Yeah. We'll give it a try? We'll give it a hell of a try.
We sure will.
We ain't you.
God's gonna get you for that. God's gonna get you for that. There's no place to run and hide, for he knows where you're at. God's gonna get you for that. God's gonna get you for that.
Pink, Orville. Pink is bubblegum.
Everybody knows when you go to the show, you can't take the kids along. You've got to read the paper and know the code of GPG and
all. Hey, there's David and Ricky.
You gotta know what the movie's about before you even go. Tex Ritter's gone and Disney's dead and the screen is filled with sex.
Whatever happened to Randolph Scott riding the trail alone? Whatever happened to Gene and Tex and Roy and Rex the Durango Kid? Oh, whatever happened to Randolph Scott, his horse plain as could be? Whatever happened to Randolph Scott, has happened to the best of me.
Damn thing won't start.
Say, sir, you think we ought to push it over against that building so these people can get in?
Everybody's trying to make a comment.
Boy, if anybody can make a live one out of him, Chloe.
It's the only movie I've really understood in years. You've got
I came here calm, and I'm going to leave here calm. And the key word is leave.
Whatever happened to Randolph Scott has happened to the industry.
Oh, if only they'd had the pill when I was young.
Alan Rocky Lane. Whatever happened to Lash LaRue, I'd love to see them again. Whatever happened to Smiley Burnett, Tim Hope, and Gene Autry? Whatever happened to all of these?
Somebody's got to rebuild Rio.
Whatever happened to Randolph Scott has happened to the industry.